that involve teaching men how to go to the climb or working on sending men to the climb. And Rue is already boofing a little hello. He is ready to get started. So our first step for you beginners out there, if you're just getting started with climb training or elevated platform training, we're going to show you how to get started. What we're looking for is just that our dog goes to the platform. So I'm going to start with Rue on my right side, show him my hand, and point to the object that I want him to go to. When he goes there, I can mark it with a verbal marker like yes, and then reward him for being there. So I'm going to lure him off of the platform to get started, just point to the object I want him to go to. When he goes to it, mark and reward, just like that. Pretty simple. So if you're a beginner at this, what I want you to work up to is sending your dog to the platform from 6 feet away. So once your dog gains confidence with jumping on it from just a couple of feet away, then take a couple of steps away and try it again. So we're gonna show you that next step. So Rue, come here. Okay, so I'm gonna ask him to come over here and then send him to the platform again. He's able to do it. Yes, good job. Mark and reinforce for that. Get that little cookie crumb right there for me. All right, now our intermediate trainers. If you guys have been doing some climb platform training with your dogs already, then I want you guys to work up to sending your dog to the platform from 10 feet away. So build up that distance. Don't always make it harder. So you can take a couple of steps away, send your dog to the platform if they do a good job, reward them, and then sometimes make it a little bit easier by only asking them to go to it from a couple of steps away. All right, so for our intermediate skilled trainers, we want you to work up to 10 steps away or 10 feet away. Now, if you've been doing this for a while with your dog, then I'm going to give you a new challenge. I want you to be able to send your dog to the platform with a distraction in the dog's environment. So for this training challenge, I'm going to use a couple of treats on the floor for Rue. So what I'm going to do is take a couple of treats and I'm going to set them on the floor. He's going to see me do that, so they're right there. And I'm going to call him to me, then send him back to the platform without letting him get to the cookies. Rue, come touch. Rue, go climb. Good boy. You're a little thinker. I knew you knew how to do it. So if you're an advanced trainer, I want you to work on sending your dog to the climb past a distraction. Start with food, toys, or whatever your dog finds distracting, and then work up to something that might be a little bit more challenging. I'd also encourage you guys to continue working on adding distance to this as well. So get training.